Good afternoon and welcome to Audio Tree Live. Today is Tuesday, November 20th, 2012, and we're very honored to have in the studio with us Hostage Calm. Hostage Calm, Audio Tree Live. Thank you so much, you guys.
Thank you.
You're quite welcome.
Awesome. Hey, I want to hear from each of you guys, like, what did you hold precious before the age of 10? You know, outside of music, you know, for me it was like maybe Matchbox cars and Smurfs.
Those were definitely big.
So, you know, like, I want to know from you guys, what was your thing when you were a youngster before, you know, your instrument took you down the road you're on now?
Legos were huge.
Yeah, Legos.
Legos were a very, very big part of my life.
Dude, I know what mine is, hands down. Tom?
What is it, Nick?
Come on, Nick, tell us.
Magic the Gathering cards.
Oh, yes, dude.
Which I still play.
Before you were 10?
Oh, yeah, dude.
That's wild.
Wow.
Magic the Gathering. Dude.
I was like 9. That's
you were a prodigy.
Yeah, that counts.
That's like sort of Dungeons and Dragons, but a different.
Well, yeah, you know.
No, dude, I'm down.
But it's way cooler. It's way, you know.
Damn. Magic, dude. Super rare. Get the $80, like super rare card that defeats all the cards.
Yeah.
I know how to play.
So money wins everything.
All right, Tom, how about you, man?
It has to be the Ninja Turtles. I was a Ninja Turtle for Halloween at least 3 years before I was 10.
Yes.
My grandmother actually sewed me a Donatello costume.
Donatello.
I had, like, teal green sweatshirt and sweatpants, and she sewed on like the muscles and stuff like that. It was pretty great.
That's so rad. Do you still have that thing?
Somewhere.
Dude.
Somewhere.
Save it for your kids. That's the bomb.
I think I'll save it for the stage. For a show. Yeah.
You guys could all go down as the, you know, turtles, and he could, you know, he'd be Shredder or something. You know what I'm talking about? All right, Tim, how about you, man? What before age of 10, what was precious?
I think I was pretty passionate about Batman.
Yeah.
Batman.
you know, he's so like dark and conflicted, you know. When I was like 4 or 5, that was really appealing to me, that like.
Like the animated series or the comic books or action figures or just all of it?
I don't know. I never quite had the comic books, but at the time I think there was like an animated series. Also like the Michael Keaton Batman was going on.
Yeah.
Early 90s, so I definitely was into that.
Shaboom, shaboom, dope. You know, and then we still got Batman today, which is still, you know, beating our ass.
Yeah. True.
Dark Knight is still awesome, killing. Yeah. John, how about you, man? Yeah.
Just ruled my life.
Who were your dudes?
Oh, the Yankees.
Yeah?
Yeah, the Yankees. Old school Yankees.
Yeah, no, that's cool,
Don
man.
Don Mattingly and stuff like that.
Dude, Mr. Baseball.
Don Zimmer.
Daryl yeah. Raspberry.
Daryl Raspberry.
Eric Jeter.
Dude, we're in the studio with Hostage Calm. It's beautiful to have you in here, guys. Thanks so much for being here.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you. This one's called Woke Up Next to a Body.
Your father's blessing when we've been downstairs undressing, knowing not the time it takes. When your thoughts start to stray and you see the pillars in me and hear the lonely voice and mass are singing you to sleep. I woke up next to a body.
Hostage Calm, Audio Tree Live. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
It sounds like a clap track.
Right? It's like our Laverne and Shirley.
Hostage sitcom.
Hey, if you could turn the clap track up.
I think that'd be good.
Get them a little more amped.
Bolster us a little.
Hey, I want to hear from you guys in regards to the day you got your first instrument.
Whoa.
Or maybe the day you sang first and realized you wanted to sing bigger than just singing.
Well, my mom got me like an acoustic guitar from the flea market. I'm not really sure how functional it was, and I didn't really play it much. And then I kind of got into drumming. So I got a drum pad. It's probably the first like real instrument I had. And then I smashed the guitar because I thought that was really rock and roll. And my mom was like heartbroken. So I felt bad. But
sorry,
singing just happened because, you know, I was playing the drums and I started writing songs. And a natural progression to start singing them.
Right on. Thanks, Seymour. How about you, Nick?
My first guitar was a Yamaha knockoff of a Stratocaster.
Yeah.
$75, pretty high end. I think it was American made. I had that, and I don't know, man. I was a big video game kid.
Yeah.
Which was, I don't know.
What was your game?
Oh man, Counter-Strike.
Oh, big time.
Oh yeah,
big
dude. Time. Yeah. And I remember getting my guitar and like sitting there playing with my friends and just being like, you know what, I'd rather be playing guitar right now. And thankful for that. Otherwise, yeah. I might be like a professional Counter-Strike player or something.
No, dude, you made the right choice.
I don't think it's as cool. It's pretty close, but, you know.
Lucrative, though.
Tom, what about you, Tom?
I'm not really sure what happened first. You know, I started playing trumpet in 7th and 8th grade band.
Cool.
And right around the same time, I wanted to start taking guitar lessons, but the instructor encouraged me to do piano first, so I took piano for a couple of years, but I was just like not interested, and unfortunately didn't really retain any of the musical knowledge from that. But shortly after that, I got an Ovation electric guitar, and they usually only make acoustic guitars. So this was like a low end.
It was like the breadwinner or something like that?
Something like that. It was like a low end. The thing weighed like 50 pounds. And it was just like the heaviest, like most metal looking guitar. And yeah.
It was like Paul Bunyan's axe and shit.
As you can see, we started our musical, you know, lives with very high end gear. Flea market guitar. Yamaha. $75 thing. I
think mine was $75 also.
Dude, what we're talking here is substance over style. That's all we're talking about. You guys got it, man. You don't need the fucking flashy things. Ooh, pardon my mouth. How about you?
When I was a little guy in school, I started playing violin at a really young age. But that, like, you know, didn't have, like, a really cool aesthetic attached to it.
Yellow card didn't do it.
You have to tell them about the picture.
Yeah.
I actually went to high school for violin performance and like music theory and shit. And there's a rad picture in like a citywide periodical. This is a few years ago. But I'm wearing like a Casualties t-shirt and I have a rad mohawk. And I'm like playing the violin, like sitting in the chair. It's pretty classic.
Nice.
It's like on the cover of this like newspaper.
Yeah.
It's pretty awesome.
Yeah, that's
like
really
13.
Rad, man. Better tweet that shit. Put that up, dude. I want to see
that. It's going to be an album cover.
Sure. At least like liner note. It's got to be in there. How about you, John?
I'm trying to take my
first instrument.
My stepmom insisted on taking me to a tag sale one day.
Yeah.
And so I was like, all right, you know, we'll go. I was like a little kid, you know, like maybe 8, 9, I don't know. And I saw a couple of bass guitars. They didn't even have like a name brand on them or anything like that. And they're $5 a piece.
Get it.
I had to beg her to buy me the bass. It's like, come on, please. It's only $5. And she finally bought it for me.
Nice.
And then never looked back after that.
Did you just rip it up, dude?
I learned how to play Peaches by the Presidents of the United States.
Yeah.
I played it completely wrong. Completely wrong. But I thought it was right.
Played it, though.
But I did play it.
You played it. That's awesome.
I listened to that record at 3 in the morning in the van the other day.
I heard it and I was like, holy crap. I thought about that bass.
John was air bassing when you had that mark on.
Oh, another note. Later on, I sold that bass, that same bass, for $75.
Whoa! Whoa. That's pretty good profit, John.
I kind of wish I hung on to it, though. It was my first, right? My first guitar.
Musical relic. We're in the studio with Hostage Calm. It's a beautiful day. Thanks for being here, you guys.
Nick Balzano.
Audio Tree Live. Beautiful, you guys.
Thank you.
I'd love to hear from you guys in regards to a profound concert experience that you witnessed. Concert that blew you out of the water.
Yeah, that's a good question.
Blew me out of the water.
You know, maybe even redefined how you watch and look at music and listen to music. You know, there's always, we all have a handful of shows like that that sort of up the level of the barometer of the deal.
Well, honestly, not to to put John on the spot, but John played in a band called With Honor. And when we were going to shows, you know, I was listening to music. I downloaded on Kazaa and, you know, kind of, I had this idea of punk, and it existed in, you know, 1978 to 1983, you know what I mean? And I had this concept of punk and hardcore and some ska punk and stuff. But I didn't really know it was like a modern local and national community. Like, I didn't understand that that really existed. I had gone to some local shows of like bands at my high school and a couple local bands. But I saw With Honor play. I can't remember exactly where. It might have been Cromwell Knights of Columbus. It might have been in Wallingford, because we saw them a bunch of times. But they were sort of the band that had this big inspirational performance. You know, it was all these kids stage diving and singing along, and everybody was invested in it, and it was epic. You know, and that was something that certainly had a big impact on me, that music would be this big, epic event, and that it would inspire people, and it would be about something. A lot of the punk I was listening to up till then, there was some political punk, but a lot of it was also just self-destructive. And a band like With Honor was very positive, and they had this message that was central to their sound. So seeing With Honor, I think, was a big thing for me.
All about participation.
Absolutely.
Awesome. Check out John's got a perma smile over there. He's like, yeah, With Honor was bad as hell, man. How about you, Tom? Profound concert.
I got to say, I think this local band, the Flaming Tsunamis, they're like a ska, I guess they were a ska band. They were much more than that. But I think the first time they broke up, they did a reunion show at this place called the Madison Arts Barn in Connecticut. And, you know, it's kind of this small, like, community-like space. And there was like 400 people there. And I just remember, you know, I had seen them before and hadn't really known about them like that much. And then I had listened to all the music and found that they broke up. But they were always really involved in like the local scene. You know, a couple of the guys had a label and they were always booking shows and supporting local bands and booking touring bands coming through. And, you know, that show was really kind of a culmination of their involvement in the community. Like, so many young kids were getting into music through them, and you know, it was just kind of a celebration of that. And I was young then, and I just kind of realized that I wanted to be involved in like a local music community beyond just playing my guitar. So
super rad,
man. Yeah,
awesome. Nick, how about you, man?
Yeah, I was actually the first show I ever went to that like my parents didn't take me to, you know, like a Beach Boys concert or something, was to see the Flaming Tsunamis in this venue in Hamden, and there were like 250 people there. And I went to Catholic school my entire life pretty much, and then went to public high school, so I knew no one, and I met a few people, and they were like, yo, you gotta come to this concert and check out this band. So I went to this show, and it was like the cool, like, to this day, they are exactly what I would hope our band is for Connecticut. Like, no one got hurt at their shows. Everyone had fun. They used to do, like, wild things where they'd give everyone in the crowd, like, pool noodles. And they'd just, like, run around and, like, hit each other with pool noodles, like, to this, like, ska punk band. But it was, like, the coolest thing. And once I saw them, I just started going to shows, like, freshman year of high school all the time, and awesome. they pretty much got me into music.
Really cool, man. Awesome. Tim.
I was gonna say both of those. Knocked them down one by one. But I guess I'll tell a short story about how we were playing in Glasgow, and
It wasn't a King Tut's Wawa Hut, was it?
I forget the venue.
We did play at King Tut's one time.
The Academy?
Might have been it.
Maybe. Anyway, Chris and I legged it like 2 miles across Glasgow the minute after we played.
In the rain,
to see Mick Jones of The Clash do like a thing. It was called Justice Tonight, and it was raising money for this like football massacre thing, the Hillsborough disaster. Yeah. But it was really like a really just wild moment in my life, like when it hit me that I was running across Glasgow to see the dude from The Clash play a show.
Did he do like big Audio Dynamite stuff, or was it all this sort of new thing?
I don't think he did any bad stuff.
He did like a Clash set.
Yeah, okay. It was rad. He did like a 10 song Clash set.
He did a lot of his songs. And then he's like, oh, this one was John's song or something like that.
Right.
And they played London Calling.
It was a really great experience. And it was just mind blowing.
Rad.
Yeah.
Epic.
So many dad punks.
So many dads. Yeah.
Like dudes who definitely saw it back then, reliving it now.
Yeah, man. They can't let it go. They're like, it's back. We got to go check it again. That's real. All right. John. Metallica.
Yeah. I mean, that was one of the biggest influences on my young life as far as getting into music and shit.
Where was the first time you saw him?
The Hartford Civic Center. So, you know, it started there, and I think maybe more in a more relevant way. Shai Hulud, actually, was like a huge inspiration to me. That band, when I saw them live, they blew my mind with the intensity that they had, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And actually, that goes back to what Seymour said, and that's, I think, Shai Hulud is why I started the band with Honor. And I wanted to have that like intense, inspirational vibe to the band. And I mean, apparently Seymour got that vibe from us, which is awesome. You know what I mean?
Mission accomplished.
I love it. You guys are talking about your motivations and inspirations, and you guys are all helping each. You guys are part of each other. It's an incredible thing to witness here today. We're in the studio with Hostage Calm. This is Audio Tree Live.
The with honorable John Ross presiding on the drums. It's a sad time to be young.
Message call. Audio Tree Live. Hey, what's the craziest thing on your guy's rider, man?
Case of water.
Far out.
Yeah, dude. Tostitos chips and salsa.
Yeah, what type
like
of
that.
Tostitos? Like the scoops or like
just the cheapest one.
The rounds. Yeah.
I don't know. Do we have a rider?
Do you guys?
I think, you know what? Actually, I think we did make one. Like the first like big tour we did, we're like, oh man, we got to make a rider. Obviously, we're not going to get anything. But do you remember what was
yeah,
on that?
You gotta put some
we had a few like.
Yeah, our manager buddy was just like, just put anything. You know, I mean, you probably won't get it, but you might.
I think crudité was on there. Maybe hummus and veggies.
Hummus and veggies.
Isn't there like a standard one where like they like it specifies the temperature of the water and the size of the
warm towels.
No red M&Ms. And yeah. The wigs the other night they got scratch offs. Like nice.
That's
lottery.
Good. Really? That's good.
Wow.
Yeah, that's a really good one.
That's
genius.
I was just going to ask for like $1,000 on the rider.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
You get that
like,
with the scratch off.
You could.
You might
you
be
could.
Able to. You could be there.
You can get more.
Think about how many scratch off you accumulate across a tour. Like,
wow, yeah. That's not
yeah, if you got like,
idea.
You know, a few a day.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Well, plus, we wouldn't bear any of the losses.
Right. Powerball tickets.
Yeah, hook it up.
That's going on the rider.
There's no risk.
Right.
Only reward. Yeah.
We're in the studio with Hostage Gom. Thanks for being here. You guys.
Thank you.
Find the stars aligned, scarf up for this needed, preserve them my contempt. Emerald beyond the obscure lights, comfort gets depleted. Know that you won't find us retreating. Suburban sprawl, creeping ever closer. Never will know why I've been. My family's wet, so I'm prepared to cope with their confinement. Reminded me of the times when I sit down and cry and hope to find someone who won't hurt you as much as I know I do.
Guys, it's like the end of November. We're heading into December. It's holiday time. True. What are your favorite parts about the holidays? I enjoy Thanksgiving, the football, food, family, friends, you know, that, or the quadruple F. You know, hook that up. You know, and there's no real pressure with Thanksgiving. You know, I was just gonna make sure everybody's sorted out with a present.
True.
Yeah. Christmas is a beautiful thing, but it can be like, dude, get me this, get me that. It can be a little crazed.
I think Thanksgiving's a little more volatile though, because then, like, you know, you're like 15-year-old me, and you're like, you know, like
we're celebrating.
There's a genocide against the Native Americans, man, and like. And we're eating, like, you know, turkey, man. This is bullshit, you know what I mean? So
yeah, no,
it's
I'm
a little
with
more,
you on
it's
that.
A little more
I think as long as
hostile.
There's awareness there, I think it's all
absolutely.
Good.
Yeah, yeah, and I think for us, I did an interview recently with AP about vegetarianism on the holidays, and I said something to the effect of, you know, is Thanksgiving supposed to be a time where we are taking, or we are being greedy, or supposed to be a time where we're celebrating life? And I think that no matter the origins of it, I think there is something special about Thanksgiving and what it means in sort of popular culture and what it means to the people around you. You know what I mean?
Definitely brings people together.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and I think on that day people do give more than they take. I mean, absolutely. There's always the uncle who eats more than he did the dishes, but you know what I'm saying. What about you, Tom? What's your favorite part? You guys have separate things. You guys all living with that?
Well, I actually live in Boston now, but the way this tour works, we're playing in Michigan tomorrow, and then we have Thanksgiving off, so we're driving overnight back to Connecticut. So it's a little hectic to make it. Yeah, it's a travel day. But we'll get there. We'll get to eat dinner with our families. And our friend's band, this band called Sweet Weapons, is on tour also, and I invited them to come to my parents' house for Thanksgiving. So my dad's birthday is actually this weekend.
Happy birthday, Dad.
Happy birthday, Dad. And so it's going to be a party. I'm looking forward to that.
Excellent.
It's going to be a good time.
Excellent. Good to hear. Yeah. Good to hear. Nick, how about you, man? Holidays.
I'm just happy that this conversation isn't about Christmas. I hate Christmas. Well, I don't hate Christmas. I like watching the movies.
But the commercials drive you crazy?
Well,
they start them in like August now, dude.
Dude, I've worked at a grocery store for like 6 years. It was like the second job I ever had, and they start playing Christmas music at like in October, after Halloween.
Oh,
that's
man.
It. Yeah,
see,
so
it used to be
October.
After Thanksgiving, but now it's like.
Oh
after
no,
Halloween.
Not at all. Yeah, November 1st, that's all they play. So by the time it gets to Christmas, and like you're going to your parties, you know, and they're playing all the Christmas music, it's like. I literally walk in, and the first thing I want to do is just click it off.
Well, I want to kind of flip this on you and ask you what your favorite Christmas album is, but it sounds like maybe you don't have one.
I have favorite Christmas songs.
Yeah.
What is it? Well, Mariah Carey, All I Want for Christmas is You. The Kinks, Father Christmas.
There you go. Shaboom, shaboom.
Those are probably my two favorite.
Put those two on repeat, dude. That's all you need. Maybe Nat King Cole.
I'll be home for Christmas.
It's a legend.
Tim, holidays.
Man, I feel like holidays and like a lot of other like high pressure social situations. I drink a lot early in the day and I'm asleep by noon. So
that's an early start then.
Because we have this day off on Thanksgiving. Every Thanksgiving, literally. Yeah, I fall asleep. Yeah, but
that's good, man.
Yeah,
tryptophan.
I don't know. I'm looking for. It'll be good. Good to get that rest.
Day of rest. Yeah. Awesome, John. How about you, man? The holidays.
Ah, jeez. I guess I'd have to say second to my mom's vegetarian cooking.
Yeah.
Would probably be the movies, like for Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Planes, Trains, and Automobiles.
Yes.
Awesome.
It's a great Thanksgiving movie. And then for
totally
for Christmas, I like Changing Places or whatever with Eddie Murphy and Dan
Trading
Aykroyd.
Places.
Oh,
that's
a classic. Yeah.
I love the holiday movies. You know?
I'm a sucker for Christmas Vacation.
Oh, yeah.
Chevy Chase.
Yeah. Classic.
But the second, don't watch the sequel. Have you guys seen the sequel?
No.
It's like mastered on videotape, man. It's like a bootleg movie, man. We're in the studio with Hostage Calm. This is Audio Tree Live.
Now it's all falling down. Don't
Hostage Calm, Audio Tree Live, C-Mar, Tom, Nick, Tim, John in the house. They're playing the House of Blues tonight, Chicago, with Streetlight Manifesto and Lion Eyes. Everybody go see this show. Go see these cats. It's an early one. And then they got a nice little leg in front of us. Pontiac, Providence, Boston, New York, Nashville, El Paso, Phoenix, Santa Ana, San Diego, Los Angeles, San Fran, Sacramento, Albuquerque, Oklahoma City, St. Louis, Columbus, Philadelphia, Boston. And then an album release in Hamden, baby. Please remain calm. December 15th at the Space. Dope.
Hell yeah.
Hostage Dope. Calm is out there grinding. Let's give a big round of applause to our videographers today.
Hey, thank Justin, you, guys.
Justin, Jane, Megan, and Brian. Our engineers, Rick, Jake, and Patrick, Michael, Adam, Lauren, Coltrane in the house. This has been Audio Tree Live for Tuesday, November 20th, 2012. We've been in the studio with Hostage Calm. My name is DJ Evil Vince. Everybody have a very safe and beautiful night. Treat each other well, y'all. Good night.
Woo! Woo!